slacking off. Hey.
Ooh. Scared the life out of me, mate.
I didn't mean to. Picking up any tips?
I don't think they like the short strays here.
You didn't mind them, did you?
I love this track. Always do well here. Well, used to.
How are you doing, Devon?
Me? Golden, mate. Loving life.
Yeah, sure.
You know what it's like to leave all this behind, don't you?
That's the most difficult thing I've ever done.
Yeah, well, like that. But, I didn't choose this, Caspar. I didn't.
I know.
You came back, right? How's it treating you?
Ups and downs.
How's our old teammate doing?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't think he's happy here.
He still thinks he belongs in that top team, see? He's never let it go. That's the problem. You know, I could have a word with him. I mean, if you think that might help.
It's all a bit dead.
Yeah. Oh, I understand.
No, Devon, I mean it.
Yeah. Scouts on him, mate.
Hey, we need your input on this one.
Did Caspar really want you to talk to AIDEN?
I read between the lines. Look, Casper's good at lots of things, but I know people. Yeah, I know how to get in their heads. And I wanted to help Dad, help the team, so,
Leave me alone.
Listen, I'm just saying, mate, if you were such an incredible driver, you wouldn't be a connoisseur, would you? I'm sorry, it's the truth, no offense.
Well, maybe I won't be here next season.
Dude, you know what your problem is?
Yeah, you.
You think you're better than the team. I remember when AIDEN Jackson was just happy to be behind the wheel of an F1 car. We all liked that guy far better than this one.
You never liked me.
No, but Casper did, once upon a time. Oh, you're different now. You think you're too good for the team, your head's stuck in some imaginary big three-seating cloud cuckoo land, mate. No. You have got to drive the car you're in.
You're lecturing me about ego.
A subject I know well.
Oh, right. I get it. So you're allowed to be cocky, but I'm not. Is that it?
There's a difference.
How can there possibly be a difference?
This isn't. This isn't you, mate.
Oh, get lost. Be true to myself. Drive the car I'm in. The wisdom of Devon Butler. Should I be living my best life too?
Just drive the car you're in, mate, yeah? Ciao.
We'll be right back. Tudor Bay hosted a Grand Prix that briefly ran in the 60s and 70s, but the Garden City re-entered the calendar for good in 2008. We missed it for a couple of years, but it was great to come back to the Singapore Grand Prix. We're here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit today, located in the heart of Singapore. The circuit consists of 23 corners, 13 to the left and 10 to the right. It's a track that's incredibly technical, so don't expect to see the drivers taking too much of it at full throttle. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and starting next to them is George Russell. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Sainz, Oscar Piastri, Perez, Fernando Alonso, Verstappen, Leclerc, Norris, Joe, Ocon, Stroll, Jackson, Mayer, De Vries, Magnussen, Tsunoda, Gasly, Bottas, Sargent, Hülkenberg, Sargent. And now it's time to head down to the track. Well, it's a beautiful night here at the Marina Bay Circuit, and as ever, a really enthralling Singapore Grand Prix ahead of us.
That's right, Crofty. And while there's not many surprises at the top of the standings right now, there's a lot to watch out for further down the pack.
One driver I'll be definitely keeping my eye on is Connor Sports' AIDEN Jackson. He's been less than consistent so far this season.
AIDEN, you know what you're doing here. Let's lock in and give it everything. Show us what you got. Brings you up a place. We'll be right back. DRS enabled. Let's get past them. Overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy. Come on. this lap, give us the best in lap you can. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Stop. perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Overtake and burn off some of this energy. Gap to the car behind. Car behind. 12.8 seconds. Laps of fuel remaining. We'll be right back. laps of fuel remaining.
Shown by some of the drivers out there today, Crofty, was nothing short of incredible.
Elbows out, especially from Aidan Jacks. Loved his race today, and he finally delivered the sort of performance that we know that he's capable of. So whatever they're saying to him over at Connersport, he seems to be listening to. Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today.
Now, AIDEN, you have had your ups and downs this season, but tell me, on the whole, are you pleased with your overall performance?
Yeah, I'm really happy with what we've achieved. You know, F1 gets more and more competitive every single day, so I've really given it all this season, and, you know, today I've been able to show a little bit more of what we're capable of.
OK, I'm going to be cheeky, go straight for the jugular. If you had to choose a teammate between Callie and Devon, who would it be?
I guess I'd have to choose Callie. We've had our differences, but I'd take her over Devon any day. Plus, she's clearly the better driver.
Now, AIDEN, you have recently hinted that you're not entirely happy at Konnersport. Tell me, is it true?
I think any driver in F1 is always going to be considering their next step. Is there a team I'd be better suited to? Who knows? And a change might do me good, force me to grow as a driver. But there's nothing to report right now. You'll know when I do.
There's been wild speculation on whether or not Konnersport can even be on the grid next season, so can you tell us more?
That seems like a question for the investors, but no one's funding Konnersport as a charity. They're funding it as a business. And if a business isn't successful, then there's definitely an issue.
That's great, thank you.
Hi, Davidoff.
AIDEN, quite the answer you gave today. I didn't have you pegged as a man of business.
Yeah, I didn't really think anything of it. Of course you need to make money.
Don't we all, AIDEN?
Yeah, but Konnersport must be profitable, right?
We're still running the projections for next season.
So it's not certain, then?
Time will tell. You said it yourself, it's just business. Thanks, AIDEN.